Good morning, students. So today we are going to start the lecture about a diode AC equivalent circuit. So diode circuit, AC equivalent circuit. See, to understand this topic, you should have the prior knowledge of DC analysis. I hope you would have the knowledge of DC analysis. With that information, what I will do? So we'll be considering when you superimpose your AC signal in the DC circuit, what will happen? So what is the characteristics change? What is the AC characteristics? Everything you are going to see. That is, when sinusoidal signals are superimposed on the DC current and voltage, what is the characteristics? How it going to respond with the different frequency band? Okay, that you need to study further analysis. See, first, see, this is a circuit. Here we can see this is a combination of DC and AC, so that we used to say as a total instantaneous. How it will be represent, you need to know. It is very important. So it should be like a capital V or small d, or small v capital D. Any one combination you can follow, it's up to you. When you go for the DC analysis, it should be all uppercase. It should be capital V, and subscript it should be capital D. When you go for AC analysis, it should be all small. You can see here, small V, small D. It should be like this. The total instantaneous is nothing but the combination AC and the DC parameters. Okay, it's very important to understand the different notation before you starting to read the theoretical part. This RD is a small resistance, so we'll see further why it was drawn in the analysis. Okay, so the small signal analysis will come here. That is, total instantaneous VD equal to steady state solution plus time varying solution. You can see here it was a capital VD in subscript. Similarly, small v small d, that's total instantaneous, nothing but a capital V small d or small v capital D. Anything you can follow. See here, this is a graph which is plotted for diode voltage versus diode current. But see carefully, this is for total instantaneous. See, small I capital D, here small v capital D. Here you can plot like a capital I small d also, same, it's up to you. Okay, so here you can see the AC was superimposed here. See, AC was superimposed in the DC point, in the DC point. So here you will be getting output current, here you will be getting output voltage. Okay, the slope of this region is 1 by RD, because we have plotted for ID versus VD. So that's why the slope was 1 by RD. Hope you clear. So here it was clearly mentioned, there is ID of T, that is a time varying signal, it was mentioned here. So here when you come to the circuit, see, you should be very clear here. Yeah, AC was superimposed. That means your DC and AC are dead in one circuit, and seeing the response, right? That is total instantaneous. The total instantaneous is nothing but the combination of DC and AC, and your diode voltage, this also total instantaneous voltage, that is a response of DC and AC. That's what we want. In the next slide, we will be seeing what is the separate circuit for DC and AC analysis in the last slide. Okay, so here I will come with your mathematical expression. Okay, for your better understanding, see, this is with respect to when you are not applying any AC signal, that is with respect to the DC part. So that is ID equal to IS exponential of VD divided by eta V of T. See, I can write your total instantaneous is nothing but a capital VD plus small VD, that is a combination of DC and AC. The total instantaneous current, which is given as Id of t equal to Is exponential of Vd divided by eta V of t. So this one I can write like a combination of DC and AC. I hope you are clear, right? I was separating in the next step DC and AC separately. Then I am bringing this equation in place of Is exponential Vd by eta V of t. I am bringing this value Id. So it was replaced by this equation. Now we'll go with the power series expansion. You know this is a basic formula for e power x, the power series expansion. With that, I'm going to write for this one. So what you'll get, you'll be getting this expansion. I'll be taking only this two one, because you know the condition Vd divided by V of t is less than one. With that consideration, I'll be writing this equation as a from the power series expansion. I hope you are clear. So this should be like a Is, okay, Is should be in the subscript, so typical error. Okay, so like a Id of t equal to capital Id plus Id Vd eta V of t. So from this I am writing this as a Id, small Id. So here Id gives a clear picture, capital Id Vd divided by eta V of t, clear? So Id is nothing but a capital Id Vd by eta V of t. So from this I can write your Id by when you rearrange this equation and you manipulate this equation, Id by Vd equal to Gd, that is a reverse of R. We'll be getting, I can write like a Id by empirical factor. This is empirical factor, material based parameter Vt. So Rd, that is nothing but a 1 by Gd, you know from the graph. So eta V of t divided by Id. So this is empirical value. So it varies from 1 to 2. So here I said already, it's given, you can see the DC analysis circuit or AC analysis circuit. This is only the focus parameters are DC and this focus parameters are AC. And what are the parameter which is represent here, all are, you can see it's all are DC. So here they bring the piecewise linear model, that is a DC model they bring. The small signal like RD resistance, you know RD resistance is nothing but a eta V of t divided by Id. So with that, we have drawn the DC analysis and AC analysis separately, and this is giving the picture of your final representation, that is tangent line, that is 1 by RD. And RD, you know that is a small signal resistance. The RD is nothing but a eta V of t divided by Id. The equation of tangent line can be written as capital small I capital D equal to 1 by RD small V capital D minus the contained voltage, it was represented by capital V capital D naught. So with that, today lecture is over.